Hi everyone, welcome again to my channel. Today our topic is about module English 10, quarter 1, module 6, lesson 1, entitled Exploring Range of Decks. This time we are going to discuss different range of decks. But before that, of course, if you are new in this channel, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and also click the notification bell para palagi kang updated sa aking bagong video. And of course, please share also. Alright, let us start. What are the range, different range of text? First, number one is narrative text. When you say narrative text, it is a text that tells a story, like this one. It tells a story about these monkeys. Next range of text is nonfiction. When you say nonfiction, these are essays which discuss certain topics. And then number three, okay, number three is poetry. Poetry are texts written in stanzas, like this example. Okay, now let us go back to the narrative texts. Now, what are the different kinds of narrative texts? Number one is short story. When you say short story, it includes one or more characters, one plot, and one single impression. Number two, science fiction. Science fiction is a story based on the impact of actual, imagined, or potential science, like this example. All right, number three, fairy tale. When you say fairy tale, it is a story about fairies and other magical creatures, like this example. Okay, number four, myth. Myth is often pertaining to actions of the gods, like those stories with the Greek mythology. Okay, this is an example. And then number five, legend. When you say legend, it is a fictitious narrative about origin of things. Paano ba nagsimula o nag-umpisa ang isang bagay? Okay, like this example. This is the legend of an athlete. Alright, number six, biography. Biography is a narrative text of a person's life, usually written by others. Okay, like this example. Number seven, autobiography. Autobiography is a narrative text of a person's life wherein the author is also the main subject, like this example. Alright, next is epic. When you say epic, it narrates the deeds and adventures of a hero, like this example. Okay. Or number nine, novel. Novel is a story which contains complex plot involving many characters, like this one. Okay, number 10 is fable. Fable is a story which deals with animals and inanimate things who speak and act like humans. Pag sinabi natin fable, ang mga characters dito ay binubuo ng mga hayop na nagsasalita na parang tao. Like this example. Okay. Now, let us discuss this non-fiction text. Non-fiction text includes the following. First, discussion. Discussion text presents a reason and balanced overview of an issue, like this example. Number two, explanatory. Explanatory text explains how or why a certain thing is done, like when explaining a process. ito yung nagpapaliwanag kung paano ang isang bagay ay ginawa o yung mga hakbang sa paggawa ng isang bagay. Or like this example. Number 3, instructional text. When you say instructional text, it includes rules for games, recipes, instructions for making something, and directions. Again, instructional text means it includes rules for games, recipes, instructions for making something, and directions. Another one is persuasive text. When we say persuasive text, it convinces the readers to believe in the author's opinion. Pinapapaniwala ang mga nagbabasa o nanonood o kinukumbinsi ang mga nanonood o nagbabasa. Okay, like this one. Alright. Number 5 is recount. When we say recount, it provides an account of events. Kinukwento yung mga pangyayari. Okay, like this one. And then number 6, report. Report means it presents information in an objective way. Like this example. Alright, now let us discuss poetry as another range of text. We have different features of poetry. Number 1 is free verse. When we say free verse, it is not restricted by conventions of forms or patterns and does not have to rhyme. Pag sinabi natin free verse, wala itong sinusunod na pattern. Walang rhythm, walang rhyme, walang stanza, walang meter. That is why it is called free verse. Just like this verse from the Bible. Wala siyang pattern na sinusunod. Next feature of poetry is structure. It means it follows a consistent framework based on features such as line, length, syllable count, or line length, syllable count, rhyme pattern, rhythm, and meter. Ito yung kabaliktaran ng free verse. Dito sa structured, mayroon ng bilang. Binibilang yung syllable, mayroong rhyme pattern, may rhythm, at may meter. At mayroon din siyang stanza, like this one. Okay, next feature is visual. When I say visual, the words are presented to create an image or to convey a visual image. Gumagamit ng mga salita na naglalarawan para maipakita yung tunay na larawan. Alright, like this one. Alright, let us now summarize what we have discussed in this video. We have different range of texts. Number 1 is narrative text. We have non-fiction text. And the third one is poetry. I hope you have learned something in this video. Check out my other videos about other modules and also about different rules in grammar. Thank you very much for watching. See you again.